Pleasant good morning to you. I'm Thomas Blackwell, your announcer for Central Baptist Church. During this time of crisis in our world today, the coronavirus that's sweeping our nation and our world, we want to take these times to worship our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And we take you to a message from Central Baptist Church, Dr. Luther B. Keith, bringing the word today.
Everybody take your seats. We're going to talk about today sanctification, a new life before God. Amen. Sanctification. A lot of times this word has put fear in a lot of us, but the word sanctification means set apart for God's service. Yeah. I don't care if you're usher, choir member, janitor, you are set apart to do this service for the Lord.
Yeah.
I need a little volume, Brother Blackwell, over there. Paul is talking to the church. The meaning of sanctification, it means to be set apart for God's service. A lot of you know the scripture, Romans 12, 1, verses 1 through 2, tell us about that we should present our bodies a living sacrifice. Uh-huh. It means to have a holy life.
Yes.
Man.
It means that we have a yielded life.
Yes.
When God has saved us and sanctified us, see, we're striving to perfection. As we grow and as we pray, we'll grow into maturity.
Amen.
Every day we should be striving for excellency.
Yes.
In the gospel, striving to be the best people that we can be.
Amen.
Not for no shape, form, or fashion, but that God might be glorified.
Yes.
You see, when we are sanctified and standing before God, that don't mean that you are. But God has saved us and brought us out of darkness into the marvelous light. That don't mean that we're going to look down on those that we have left.
Well,
because the Bible says, consider yourself, we haven't been saved always.
Yeah.
This is what happened to a lot of us. When the Lord blesses us to come out of darkness, a lot of times we forget where we come from.
Well, yeah.
And we forget those that we have left behind.
Well,
you see, when God saved you, you need to let him set you apart and let your life get right and have a yielded life before God, and then you can go back and try to bring those out that you left behind.
Well,
you see, we're living in a life where we are leaving too many people behind.
Uh-huh.
I got mine and I don't care about you.
Yeah.
We got those that are destitute, those that are hurting,
yeah.
Those that don't have no hope.
Well,
little children being set on doorsteps.
Well,
little children being sacrificed.
All right.
Being killed, sitting on cold benches.
Well,
and this is why God needs men and women that are set apart for his service.
Amen.
See, when God has saved you and have set you apart for his service, then you are real and you are serious and you are concerned and dedicated about what you are doing.
Yeah. Amen.
It's one thing that Reverend Carroll said in the early service that, you see, we got a lot of folks that we are serving God out of fear. And we afraid that if I don't do certain things, God is going to drop a nickel on me. And when I say a nickel, it means he's going to kill me.
All right.
No, God would be unjust God if he did that.
Yeah.
Because you see, God don't care no more about you than he care me, about me. Uh-huh. You see, if he called me to do a job and I don't do it, and he let me off the hook, and then you don't do it, and then he gonna cut your throat, then I think he'd be an unjust God.
Yeah.
So we got too many people that serving God through strife. Through envy and strife.
Yes.
Scared. You don't serve God through fear.
Amen.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. We serve him because we love him.
Yeah.
Now we got enough sense to know. Now I'm not talking about this kind of fear that, you know, you walk out here and somebody gonna shoot you down with AK-47. What I'm trying to get over to you is that when you saved, you're gonna have that respect for Jesus. And you're gonna fear him exactly what his word says. But see, if I have to walk around coming out here pastoring because I'm scared that God's gonna kill me, now I mean, I'm supposed to be pastored in love. Because if I'm out here through strife, and I'm out here because somebody's forcing me to be out here, then the whole thing is going to be thrown off.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
See, if you coming out here and you coming to church because somebody's forcing you to come, and we know that the church is for bad folks to come to get good.
Yeah.
But if you coming out here and say you saved, and you coming out here under force, then there's something wrong with your salvation. You need to come out here because you're saved, you love the Lord, and it's right to come. The necessity of sanctification. It is necessary to be sanctified that we might see God. It is necessary to grow in the Lord. It is necessary to please God. See, if you ain't living right, you ain't going to grow.
Amen.
And we're not talking about, hey, we know there ain't none of us God.
Well.
But that don't give you no contract to go around and be a liar.
Right.
Amen.
That don't give you a contract. You can be a man of your word. You can be a woman of your word. If you tell somebody something, you need to be honest and keep your word.
Amen.
You understand what I'm saying?
Amen.
Well, all we're talking about, the necessity of sanctification. That we might see God, that we might grow in the Lord, that we might please him. And if you ain't about nothing, you sure can't please God.
Well, Lord.
Amen.
I know I'm right about it.
Amen.
We're talking about standing before God.
Yeah.
Ain't no little eyes and big U's.
Well,
every knee must bow and every tongue must confess. I don't care if you're a millionaire. I don't care if you're a ditch digger. God got a plan for all of us. Amen. There's no place for ignorance. Did you hear what I'm saying? And you should lie and say, the preacher told me this. When you got too many videos, you got too many tapes, Bible on tape, video, books, you can read for yourself. And if you don't know how to read, you got literacy training, you got all kind of training, you can educate yourself at home.
Amen. Amen.
But see, you got to be educated yourself to get educated at home.
All right.
You can't educate yourself at home when you don't know.
Well, Lord.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
How can you lead where you ain't been?
Yeah.
We know the Holy Ghost, Holy Spirit. But if you don't study, baby, when you get up, you're just going to shoot out some hot air.
Well,
only what you put in is what you're going to get out.
Amen. Amen.
The meaning of sanctification. Sanctification comes from God.
Amen.
Sanctification comes by the Holy Spirit. Sanctification comes by the Word of God.
Yes.
That's the meaning of it. It comes from God, it comes by His Holy Spirit, and it comes by His Word. If you just only gonna come here until 11 o'clock hour, how you figure you're gonna be sanctified? Saying is all right, but it ain't gonna hold you.
Well, okay.
You're gonna have to have the Word of God.
Yeah.
Faith coming by hearing and hearing by the Word of God.
Uh-huh.
I don't care, you've been in the church 50 years. It takes faith to move God.
Yeah.
Amen.
We walk by faith and not by sight.
Yeah.
I don't care how good you live. If you don't have no faith, now we know it's right to live right.
Well, Lord.
Don't say the preacher say you can live bad.
Well, Lord.
But what I'm talking about, I don't care how good you live. You pay your bills. You take care of your family. You don't lie. You don't steal. You go and you vote. You're a member to all the PTAs and everything. But you don't love Jesus.
Well, Lord.
Your life is still in vain.
Yes.
It's respecting the laws of Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
And if you just only coming to the 11 o'clock hour, and you come into Sunday school, but you ain't studied, you don't pick up your Sunday school book, you don't pick up your Bible till you get into class.
Well, Lord.
You don't pick up your Bible till you come to Bible study.
Uh-huh.
And then you confuse everybody else when you get there.
Well.
The persons who can be sanctified, the Jew, the Gentile, the church, the black, the white, the red, the green, everybody that come and accept Jesus Christ as Lord of their lives, they can be sanctified.
Yeah.
And sanctification ain't no great big mole and mountain. It means that when you accept Christ as Lord of your life, that you are set apart for the service that you God has called you to do.
Well,
you're supposed to be set apart.
Yeah, amen.
You don't slip and slide and do anything. How can you go out and minister to the world? Let me tell you something. The devil don't care nothing about you. And the devil don't care nothing about me. And you got some devils don't even care nothing about God.
Well,
and they don't care nothing about what you say to them. Now, if we're going to reach the world, you're going to have to ask God to give you some wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
How can you reach me when you're going to abuse me?
Well, Lord. Well, Lord.
You're going to get a good cussing out.
Yeah.
If I'm the devil.
Yeah.
So the Bible says that when we're among snakes, we should be wise. As what? Should be wise. That way you might reach somebody.
Mm-hmm.
I remember a long time ago when I first got saved, people run up to you and tell you pull the lipstick off and pull this off and pull that off and don't watch TV and don't do all this stuff. Then you slip around, they got your head jammed in the TV. See, I'm telling you what I know. See, we got a lot of hurting people out there. And we are in a new day now. And God is doing a new thing. And we got to reach those people for Jesus. And we got to get out of these pews and out into the arena.
Man.
And I'm not talking about out there just jaw-jacking and talking. But I'm talking about, baby, if you out there saving souls, the pool's supposed to be open. We're supposed to be baptized at every Sunday if you're really saving souls.
Well,
don't go out there talking the language of the book. Go out there, talk the message of the book. We got too many language talkers in our churches.
Amen.
And that's why a lot of our churches are dead. That's why a lot of our churches are empty. That's why you don't see a lot of folks getting saved. We're just out there talking.
Well, Lord.
Oh, I know I'm right about it.
Because
see, if everybody in here was out there evangelizing with the message and not the language, you'd have 1,000 in Sunday school.
Well,
that way I know that we got a lot of talking going on. And if you are sending them somewhere else, then that means you don't love your church, especially if in the reading of your church.
Well,
see, God ain't told you to leave somebody to the Lord and tell them to go to Reverend Glenn's. Because
well,
see, they ain't got no church of their choice when they are baby. You're supposed to lead them in baptism, teach them responsibility, and teach them in discipleship.
Well,
and then when they get grown, then they can go.
Amen.
You don't fatten nobody else's frogs for snakes. Or it's quiet, but it's good. And listen, let me tell you something. You heard what I told you the other day? A lot of us, when you see the preacher talking, what got the people in trouble in Jeremiah's day? They thought it was Jeremiah talking. But when the preacher talked to you, that's the Holy Spirit speaking through the minister.
All right.
And when you reject it, baby, you're rejecting God. And the preacher ain't God. When you reject your Sunday school teacher, and they are trying to teach you what's right, the little children, it's just like rejecting your parents. The Lord has a word for that. That when we reject our parents, what happened to us? That our life be cut short.
Yeah.
And that when you reject the man of God, I don't care what you think, Ananias and Sapphira thought they were lying to Peter. But they were lying to God.
Amen.
And that's what's going to get a lot of us in trouble.
Amen.
Oh, that's the preacher. That's him saying that. He's fussing. That don't make sense. You know, you're talking to God.
All right.
The time when sanctification occurs. The sanctification will occur progressively. Sanctification will be completed when Christ comes. The evidence of sanctification. There will be a departed from wickedness. When you become sanctified, the more buddies you used to hang out with, the more places you used to go, listen to the more nasty jokes, you're going to start departing. You'll have a desire for worship. You ain't going to be lying about excuses coming to church. You're going to be excited about the word.
Amen.
When sanctification occurs. There will be a life of purity. You remember when you had all that old envy and strife and hatred? Couldn't stand folks. Them same folks you couldn't stand. You love them.
Yes.
You can work with them.
Yes.
You look at them. Father, forgive them. They know not what they say.
Right.
I look beyond their faults and I see their needs.
Yes.
Because I pity them. Because if they were sanctified, they would not have that attitude and they would not have that spirit. Because Christian people fought, they disagree, but they don't fall out.
Well,
it's like kids shooting marbles. We'll fight over the marbles, next 30 minutes we'll be back playing. But the parents want to kill one another. The blessings of sanctification. The sanctifications are blessed with forgiveness, that we can forgive grudges. A lot of us have grudges. We have attitudes and things in our subconscious when we were born into the world messed up. And we haven't prayed to ask God to come in and search our lives and bless us to overcome these hang-ups. Messed up attitudes. Thinking folks is after us. Can't stand certain folks. I don't care where you go, certain folks, you know their name, you don't like them. But when sanctification comes, there'll be forgiveness. A lot of times we don't forgive. We say we forgive, but we don't. When we sanctify, we really forgive. Because when people step on your toe, your tape gonna play. Oh, we'll bring it up. Long as it's going okay, fine. But don't cross me no more. Oh, it's coming up. And we can give everybody advice. Oh, you shouldn't say this, and you shouldn't say that. I like Brother Hudson. Brother Dixon like Brother White. And I tell Brother Dixon White, Hudson ain't, Brother White ain't no good, and Dixon, you know, we fighting over who's right. Everybody got their hangout, group to hang out with. But the Holy Ghost is going to cut that down.
Amen.
This is why that we're having a woman fellowship. To build healthy relationships. We got too many phony relationships in all of our churches. We want to build healthy bridges, strong bridges. Build some trust. That don't mean that I'm going to hang out at your house. That don't mean I'm going to call you on the telephone. That don't mean I'm going to be buddy-buddy with you. But that when we have come together to do some common thing, that we can do it in the Holy Ghost.
All right.
I thank God for Brother LG. I said, Brother LG, I said, I got a special place that I want the guests to. He said, nah. He said, I want them to sit wherever they can sit. He said, I don't want them bunched up. Just wherever they get a seat, that's where they sit. You know why? Because you're building bridges. So when you're in the law, I don't care if you're at a banquet, the church, in a sports arena, wherever you wind up at, that's where you should be comfortable. If you say. Y'all understand what I'm saying? Sanctified will unify you with Christ. This is the blessings of sanctification. It will unify you with the Lord. Sanctification have a perfect and give you a special position before God. That's the blessings of sanctification. Sanctification and a new life before the Lord. The meaning of it, the necessity of it, the person who can be sanctified, the times when sanctification occurs, the evidence of sanctification, the blessings of sanctification. And when we are sanctified, and when we are saved and standing before God, people will see a light shining all around you. You don't have to walk around with a sign on your back telling people who you are. You don't have to stand on a mountaintop blowing a bugle. You just be real. And the Bible says signs shall follow them that believe. don't worry about what folks say about you. You be concerned. You just make sure what they say ain't true. You ain't got time to go around worrying about what some devil say about you. You concerned about that devil, but you ain't gonna worry about it. Because when you are saved and doing the Lord's work, and I was sharing with him on the night, see, when the time you're doing something for the Lord, if you're a Christian, the devil has got you on his hit list.
That's right.
And ain't nobody exempted. And if somebody come and talk about Brother Hudson, you just remember it's somebody talking about you.
Yes.
No exemption in the Christian walk, brother. That's the coldness of it. They in the lesson of the night, it was talking about Paul done certain things for the gospel's sake. He went through certain things. See, when you say you're a Christian, there's a lot of things that you have to do that you don't want to do. Y'all understand what I'm saying? We better take account of that. Because if you're having a seminar at your church and you are a teacher, a leader, and a new member don't see you there, and every time it's coming up, they don't see you, you're becoming a stumbling block.
Amen.
That's the coldness of being a leader. That's the price that you have to pay. Have you thought about that? There are certain things that the pastor asks you to do in the church, you as a leader, and you don't do it, and people that's under you don't see you doing it, they're going to wonder what's happening to these people. And when you set yourself up to become a stumbling block, because they'll figure that you should be there.
Man.
Oh, I know I'm right about it.
Man.
It's just like the pastor. The pastor asks you to come to Bible study all the time. Wants you to go in the community and walk. Yet he laying at the house watching the football game.
Right.
And you never see the pastor out walking.
Look
up. What's going to happen to that group?
They ain't
going to
walk.
They ain't going to walk. So the same goes for the pastor. It goes for the left.
Yeah, all right.
So you put that in your pipe and smoke it. Mm. That's why we have to be careful how we walk. And we have to be careful about the positions that we're in. Because you're leading people. And there are some things that you have to take.
That's right.
And there are some things you have to do you don't want to do.
All right.
We think it's easy to say, no, I ain't going to do it. You're causing somebody to fall.
All right.
You keep on living, the Lord will show it to you. But when you become sanctified, you got to cry sometime. You got to moan sometime. And you got to stand by yourself sometime.
Yes.
And dark clouds will hover over your head.
Uh-huh.
Friends will turn their backs on you.
Come on now.
You get up early in the morning.
Yeah.
Late at night. You have a burden for souls. People, you know they ain't about nothing. But this is a price that you got to pay.
Yeah.
You got to suffer for the gospel.
Yeah.
A lot of us, we don't want to suffer.
Uh-huh.
We say that we are saved.
Yeah.
We say that we are sanctified.
Yeah.
We say that we are filled with the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
But when dark clouds fell over our head,
yeah,
and friends began to leave us and we began to hail scouts,
yeah,
a lot of times we look around and we are gone from the church.
Yeah.
But if you're saved and sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost, and have a mind to serve the Lord, you don't care if the wind might blow, get the hellhound, get on your trail. People cast their name out on a signboard. But the Lord knows. He got all power in his hand. You're serving the Lord Jesus. Mary's baby. He got all power. He called. Man didn't call you. But the Lord called. for his service, that you might glorify him, that you might praise his name, that you, I don't care if it's raining, but you're going to serve the Lord. The devil's going to try to stop you, but you got to press your way. Paul said, brother, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this is one thing I do. Forgetting about those things of behind and reaching for the things of before. I press for the mark of the high calling in Christ Jesus. I fought a good fight. I finished my course. There the crown of righteousness is laid up for me. Not only for me, but for you and for you. When you're sanctified, lead us in a song. Father, we thank you for your word. Bless us now. Breathe on your people. Those that are not sanctified. Thank you, Father. Thank you. In Jesus' name. Let us stand.
Thank you.